Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande.
Welcome to the final video on solid principles. This is a series where we were looking at various principles and how the code that violates those principles looks like. In the previous video, we have seen how the code violating interface segregation principle looks like. And before that, we have gone through Liskov substitution, open and closed, and single responsibility principle violations. Now, we will visit the last one, which is DIP, that is Dependency Inversion Principle. Well, what does the definition say? Let's have a look at the official definition. High-level modules should not depend on low-level modules. Both should depend on abstractions. Abstractions should not depend on details. Details should depend on abstractions. Well, that is quite a lot of jargons. Let's try to make light weight of this definition. In the initial part of the definition, there are words like high-level modules, low-level modules, and then later point in time, it talks about abstractions. That is, abstractions should not depend on details. It should be details should be depending on the abstractions. What does all this mean? So once again, let's just concentrate on the very first part, which is high-level modules should not depend on low-level modules. Well, what do you mean by high-level modules and low-level modules? Well, high-level modules are basically those that contain the complex business logic. And low-level modules basically contain the services to serve the business logic. So let's assume that you have a fetch account details that is a high-level module, and the module which makes the API call to user profile microservice and save it in a room database, because we are talking about from the perspective of Android application, maybe it's a local database on the device. So this is dealing with a lot of more granular lower level details of how to actually store this data. So any module that does this should be considered as low level module, because it is basically serving the purpose of a higher level module, which is actually dealing with the business logic, which is to fetch the account details. In the same way, let's assume that you want to enable certain features based on the payment confirmation. So that is the business logic. So that module which does this is a higher level module. But the module which takes care of the payment gateway integration itself, that is a lower level module that is going to serve the higher level module. So I hope now you are getting the idea of what do you mean by high level modules and low level modules. Let's look at the code to understand from the code perspective. Here we basically have three classes. One is class credit card payment, another one is PayPal payment, and then you have a class called as generic payment processor. The credit card payment has process payment function, and in the same way you have a PayPal class which also has a process payment function, and then you have a generic payment processor which is using both of these payment. So in this case, both of these, that is credit card payment and PayPal payment, both of these are low level modules. And the payment processor, which is generic payment processor, this is high level module. So now, having understood what is a high level module and low level module at the code level, what does it say next? What it says is both should depend on abstractions. Now, let me go through the code here. If you consider both of these classes, that is credit card payment and PayPal payment, both of these are concrete implementations. And in the same way, the next one, that is generic payment processor, which is a high level module, the above one are low level module. This is also concrete implementation. They are not interfaces or abstract classes. And definition basically says that they both should depend on abstractions. But in this case, they are depending on concrete implementations. And that is the reason why this code is basically violating the very first line of dependency inversion principle. Now, let's look at the remaining part of the definition, which is abstraction should not depend on details. Details should depend on abstractions. What do you mean by that? The generic payment processor is directly instantiating the instances of PayPal payment and credit card payment. So this should not have happened. And if you just recall, this is also a violation of another important principle, which is single responsibility principle, that is SRP. Because why is generic payment processor is worried about creating the instances of these PayPal payment and credit card payment? So this is dealing with lot of details, and this is violation of dependency inversion principle. And here also, the credit card payment and PayPal payment, these are basically direct concrete implementations. And that is what dependency inversion principle says, that it should not contain too much detail. It should be abstracted. We can see that in a couple of more examples. Let's take this example where you have file storage and then you have report generator. This is basically high level module and class file storage is low level module. And this is a concrete class and this is also concrete class. And both are not dependent on some kind of abstractions like interface. They are directly using the concrete class implementations. And that is also the reason why this is a violation of dependency inversion principle. And this is also getting directly instantiated here. That is a problem. So you will find that the violation of dependency inversion principle typically also violates the single responsibility principle as well. In the same way, you have another example where there is a SQLite database which has a save data and data service is directly creating an instance of SQL database. And both of these concrete classes, they are not using some kind of abstractions. So just to summarize what we have gone through in the all previous videos, initially we went through the first principle, that is single responsibility principle, which basically states that a class should have one responsibility, or in other words, a class should have only one reason to change. And then we moved on to the second principle, which is open and closed principle, which says software entities should be open for extension and closed for modification. And then we moved on to the third principle, which is Liskov Substitution Principle, which basically states objects of a superclass should be replaceable with the objects of subclass without affecting the correctness of the program. And then we went to the fourth principle, that is Interface Segregation Principle. Clients should not be forced to depend on interfaces they do not use. So this was basically in a way dealing with inheritance. And then finally, today we have gone through the code trying to understand how the violation of dependency inversion principle looks like. And the definition is high level modules should not depend on low level modules. Both should depend on abstractions and abstractions should not depend on details. Details should depend on abstractions. With this, we have now basically completed a detailed overview of how does the violation of these solid principles look like. In the next video, what we will be concentrating on, how to write a code to satisfy these conditions. Since now you know how the code violation looks like, you should be able to appreciate how the compliant code is written that adheres to the solid principle. So in the next upcoming videos, we will go through those things in a very detailed manner. So stay tuned.
That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.